Well, hello. My name is Philip Ahlqvist, and I'm the CD at Volontär. And I'm here at Alpha Baltic, enjoying myself. I think the reason why I'm here is basically because I've been part at Volontär in launching the campaign At Sweden, the globally renowned and awarded Twitter campaign for Sweden. If I can dream, it will be ongoing forever. And ever. We calculated that if all 9 million inhabitants of Sweden would have the account for a week, we would have it going for 170,000 years. So that's not likely. But hopefully as many as possible. I mean, this is not a campaign with a very clear start and a clear end. This is an ongoing process. Single action. Prove the whole brand platform of Sweden. That it's an open, caring, authentic, and progressive country. So that was the advantage. And Twitter let us spread this to, well, a potential audience of 150 million people on Twitter, which is not bad. And the risk was, of course, the advantage that people might be upset. That would seem reckless to hand over the account to people who could say anything. But so I would say that the risk and the advantage was the same. But we had planned for the risks. We knew that it was controversial. We knew the people that were going to tweet would say things that were out of the ordinary and usually not said on an official account of a country. As long as the, well, people of Sweden like the account and think it gives a diverse and true image of Sweden. I hope it will live on. When you have proven a brand promise that you believe in and you think that this might solve something for our clients' customers, or this is going to add something new, and you come up with an insight that no one had thought about before, I think that's the eureka moment of any creative, that you feel that you're adding something new. I mean, creativity and innovation goes hand in hand. So I think that just when you're sitting there and you're realizing, okay, this does not exist anywhere else, and you start researching whether or not it's possible to even develop, that's the most exciting part. The research and the development, when you have thought of something that you believe that no one else has really thought about. I believe that nowadays, when everything that is considered to be a success within advertising is spread, and shared and gets earned media space, then advertising stops being advertising and starts being popular culture. And when it becomes popular culture, we know that journalists tend to pick it up and write about it or make programs about it. Or so I think that PR and advertising will pretty soon go hand in hand. Because if you do good advertising, it will end in good PR. Actually, another thing that I think is already happening is that you see a merge between digital creatives and traditional creatives. Because we all know that the internet and reality goes hand in hand, which means that you can't think separate anymore. You can't put it into different silos. You have to merge them. So the hybrid creative is definitely going to be something that any agency will have. I think that's more or less happening right now. I think that also innovation will probably be a big part of the modern communication agency in 10 years. That product development and service development is going to have a very big part, and we will work a lot with probably technique, just like RGA is already doing with the Nike Fuel Band. I think it's a brilliant example of how a modern agency would work now. And we can also see in Droga 5 that they're coming up with a lot of innovation for their clients. So PR advertising will be merged. We won't talk about traditional or digital media anymore. And I think that innovation and research and development departments will exist in most creative communication agencies. I think that the problem is still that companies believe that they can buy attention with shitty products. I think that the solution to that is that it doesn't work anymore. You can't buy attention, you have to deserve it, which in the end will either mean the success of a company or the destruction of a company. Companies who will embrace this, that they lost the control and that their customers are in control of their brand, of their products, what is said about it. And if they embrace it and take part of it, listen more than they speak, I think that they're on their way to success. This is nothing new, but I think that's the problem with advertising, is that you think you can buy attention, but you can't. My hobbies, well, I have a wife. She's my biggest hobby. I love spending time with her. I have a dog, a little cairn terrier, a little Scottish terrier. So he's quite feisty. No, but he's fantastic. I love culture. I go a lot to the cinemas. I read a lot of books. I go to the theater. And I'm a sucker for coffee table books. Just flickering through, looking at images. That's one of my greatest, creative catalyst to just let your mind run free and see where it ends up. So I would say that my work is my biggest hobby as well and my biggest passion.